Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to prepare UAT test cases on RPA solutions. If we have created any solution for clients and these solutions are going to be delivered in their environment, so before delivering this, RPA teams are always taking care to test this type of application so that there should not be occur any error when it moves to the client's hand. So for testing this, we have to prepare some set of test cases. On that test cases, we have to verify each and every field accordingly. So we'll discuss here how to go ahead with the UAT testing in RPA project, which all type of test cases we have to make sure to be entered. So if you have not yet subscribed this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. So let's say one example here. In this website, you can find it out. There is a selection of profile picture, then the name, email, website, then the expertise in year. And here you can find it out the checkboxes and post that radio buttons are also available. In this section, you can see the alert boxes. When you click on this, alert box will appear. And finally, the comment post entering all of the detail. Once our bot will click on submit, the solution will be submitted. So let's say this is the automated phase where bot has to enter the detail and click on submit. It means one iteration will be covered here. For testing these type of solutions, we have to make sure that our accurate test cases should be available, or our number of test cases should complete our testing. So here, by using one template, I will show you how to test this applications or the solutions which the RPA team has built it. This is the main page where you have to enter the project name or the template name or the project information. So you can add a number of details here about your project. Version history is basically created with four columns. One, the dead parameter. Let's say we are working on 24th of October. So 24th October 2021 is the date and version. Let's say I'm giving as a version 1.0. Author name, let's say I'm giving as a Raigurukul. Descriptions, you can enter the version detail descriptions here. So I'm giving here just test one. Now in the second sections, let me copy this and paste it to here. Next day, if I want to update this test cases and share with the top management team to verify it. So here I am updating the version as 1.0 to 1.1. And again, I am the author. So here I am giving the same author name. Now test two will be descriptions. As you can see here, whenever you are updating any test cases, you have to define your version history so that you can track it accordingly. Post that once your test cases are ready, everything is ready, you are fully final to move into the testing phase. First, you have to verify or take an approval from the requirement owner or the product owner who has provided the requirement to you so that you can verify the requirement is successfully completed or testing is covering each and every scenario. So in test case sections, you can see process name where you have to enter the project information. Then the product owner name, UAT lead will be the manager of UAT. Run date, you can specify the run date here. Again, product owner, you can specify it if there is a sub product owner, and UAT actioner, who is the actioner of testing this. Then you can find your test case ID is basically a unique ID where you can provide the unique number so that you can search it accordingly. Let's say if test case one is going to your field, so you can highlight in the execution report. Then test steps, which all test steps you can add it to perform the actions. Here you can also add one more field like title of your test case or test scenario, you can mention it, or test name. So this will define your test name, then the steps, test data. If you have the login page, you can see what all data you can enter so that you can reach to the destination, like the name, email and website. So these all comes under test data. Expected result would be post entering all of these details, what is the expected result? The priority will specify the how much critical that test case is. Remark, if you have status while doing the testing, you have to enter the status about your executions, like pass, fail, or if you are not satisfying any criteria, maybe you can enter no run or NA, not applicable. Here in the comment sections, if you have any additional comments or notes, you can enter here. Let's say your test case is getting failed. So what is the error message you are getting? You can mention it here. Now, let's check the name. So first, when you are doing the testing or creating the test cases and verifying the name field, so we have to make sure to write all of the test cases for the name sections. So let me enter here to verify name text box. Now, in step sections, you can enter, like navigate to the name sections and enter the name field here. So you can mention it like navigate to name section and enter valid name. Let's say here you can add Rai Gurukul as a name. Expected result name should be successfully updated. Priority you can provide as a medium. Remarks, I don't have any remarks, so I am not keeping anything here. Now, while doing the testing of our text box, you have to make sure to keep in mind like the type. Type is if that text box contains string value or the numeric value or alphanumeric value. In this case, when we are dealing with the name should not be in the numeric contained. So here you have to verify the type. So type is the first component, then the minimum length. You have to provide the minimum length as well. So what is the parameter to create a test cases? So first will be type, then second length. So length will be minimum length, then maximum length. Then should not receive or should not accept the special character. And finally, should not be blank. Now, these are the five parameters which we have specified. So you have to create the test cases accordingly. Here, there is a valid scenario. So we have kept as a valid name. Now, when I am testing the minimum length, so name should not be less than 2 character. So this should not accept less than 2 character. So to enter the name of your test case here, let me add it here. To verify minimum length. Okay. Now here we have to enter less than 2 character. It means enter less than two character. Test data I am just entering R. So this should not accept R value. It will throw, or it should throw an error message. Because when we are dealing with the name, it's this is not having, when we are dealing globally, the name field is not having less than two length. So not accept, then criticality will be again medium. Fact. And the remark or in the result section, you can specify it accordingly. Third one is on the maximum length. So here I am giving max length. The max length should accept 50 character. It's totally depend on the requirement, how the product owner has specified it. So I'm just giving 50 character. Then again, through an error message. Now, when we are done here, again, you have to specify the priority, again, medium. Next things, we have to verify the special character. If user is entering the special character, that should not accept the special character value. And finally, blank. So this should not allow our solution to go name without having any data. So because this is a required field, so this should not accept blank value. Finally, when we are dealing with the email section is again a text box. So we can provide type here. Type should accept special character because at the rate symbol will be acceptable here. We can specify or as per the development rate, it should not accept any additional fields or whatever allowed characters in the email sections. Minimum and maximum length should be there, and the blank field also should not accept. So these five characters will be okay for this one. When we are talking about the website, website is again alphanumeric contained where we can, this should accept alphanumeric value. And finally, when we are entering the detail, this should accept more than 255 character. It's totally up to the website name. Now we are done here. In this sections, it should click on the years. If it is selecting 10 plus year, then they have to select the expertise. Expertise should not be blank. It should select at least one component like functional or automation or manual testing. And if this is selecting all of the fields, that is also fine. Radio button is only one selection option is will be available. And the alert box, if the person who is clicking on the alert box, this should show a pop-up message. So we have to write the test cases accordingly and test it based on the requirement. And further on, if you are done with the all of the test cases, you have to specify the tester name and the role, reviewer name and the role, UAT result, how many cases are passed, how many cases are failed. And if you have any observation, you can highlight it here and share these observations with the product owner or the end user who is going to provide the approval so that you can raise the defect accordingly. So this is how we can create a test cases of RPA projects or RPA solution using Excel file. This will be helpful. Test your all of your solution completely. So that's all about UAT test cases in RPA project. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed the session, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.